Napoleon Bonaparte, one of the most inspirational military and political leaders in human history. Born on the 15th of August, 1769, on the island of Corsica, Napoleon rapidly rose through the ranks of the military during the French Revolution. The French Revolution was a time of great poverty and suffering for the common people of France. The people of France required a strong, loyal leader that could fulfill their needs as a nation. This gave Napoleon an easy availability to the throne of France. The previous leaders of France were commonly known as the Reign of Terror. They were overthrown and executed during the Revolution due to the harsh ruling of France. As Napoleon climbed the military and political ranks, he became a second lieutenant in an artillery regiment of the French army due to the assistance of a close friend. He was appointed as artillery commander in the French forces besieging the French naval fortress of Toulon, now controlled by the British. Napoleon came up with a plan where he would place French artillery at a point that threatened the British ships in the harbor with destruction. This forced the British to leave the harbor. This plan led to the French retaking of the fortress and Napoleon's promotion to Brigadier General. After his success at the fort, he was assigned command of artillery units for the course of several years. This experience with artillery helped him to learn the power of artillery on the battlefield. He could use these skills later on in his life when he began his military conquest over Europe, Asia, and Africa. In 1802, a constitutional amendment made Napoleon first consul for life. 2 years later, in 1804, he crowned himself Emperor of France. During that time, Napoleon Bonaparte made this statement: "I saw the crown of France laying on the ground, so I picked it up with my sword." Soon after, from 1803 to 1815, Napoleon sought after a large military expansion over all of Europe, now called the Napoleonic Wars. During this large expansion of France, Napoleon worked to restore stability to post-revolutionary France. He centralized the government, instituted reforms in such areas as banking and education. He supported science and the arts, and sought to improve relations between his regime and the Pope. One of his most significant accomplishments was the Napoleonic Code, which streamlined the French legal system and continues to form the foundation of French civil law to this day. Napoleon re-established a French aristocracy and began handing out titles of nobility to his loyal friends and family. In 1803, partly as a means to raise funds for future wars, Napoleon sold France's Louisiana territory in North America to the United States for $15 million. As his military expansion continued, he needed to keep his soldiers inspired. This was achieved partly through staying close to them during the battles and campaigns. Napoleon strongly understood and sympathized with his soldiers. He said that soldiers usually win the battles, and generals get the credit for them. His soldiers fought with the confidence that with Napoleon in charge, they would surely win. Napoleon considered all aspects of his situation, be it political or military based. He once stated that, "Never interrupt your enemy when he is making a mistake." Napoleon's greatest opponent was England. Napoleon could not successfully invade England due to England's powerful armada of ships. In order to change this problem, Napoleon invaded Spain and Portugal. He did this to deprive England financially. Tactics like this helped Napoleon to defeat his enemies without even facing them on the battlefield. Napoleon's opponents were forced to wipe out his empire or face bankruptcy, and face social problems involving riots and political rivalry. Napoleon built a legacy of winning battles on the battlefield and off of them. Out of the 40 battles Napoleon fought between 1792 and 1815, he only lost a total of 6. Napoleon won many of these battles due to his excellent battle strategies and his ability to communicate with his subordinates on the battlefield. Communication is key on any battlefield. This is to keep information and orders up to date. Napoleon kept a tight set of communications on the battlefield that kept him better informed and ready to respond to any action or to make his own actions during a battle. Napoleon once said, "The secret of war lies in the communications." During Napoleon's Russian campaign, Napoleon entered Russia with over 600,000 soldiers. The Russian army led Napoleon deeper into Russia, where the French army was out of reach of their supply lines. The French army outreached all communications with France and was now in enemy territory without sufficient supplies or information. The French army froze and starved because of the cold Russian winter. The Russian winter has wiped out many armies that bravely marched into Russian territory. Napoleon's Grand Army left Russia with less than 100,000 soldiers alive or wounded. Napoleon quoted that doctors will have more lives to answer for in the next world than even we generals. The last battle Napoleon would ever fight was on June 18th at the Battle of Waterloo near Brussels. The French were crushed by the British with assistance from the Prussians. Napoleon made a wise comment that to have good soldiers, a nation must always be at war. Every country Napoleon had been at war with had been gaining experience from fighting him. They learned how he fought and how he reacted to their movements. Napoleon's enemies gained political experience and made pacts to work against him in all aspects of Napoleon's conflicts he had been fighting against many odds. Napoleon had been at war against more than 4 different nations. Napoleon still conquered much of Europe, Africa, and Asia. His tactics and ideals affected many people, nations, and leaders throughout much of modern history. Napoleon's empire had spread from France all the way to Russia and Egypt. His campaign changed the map of Europe forever. Napoleon Bonaparte's greatest legacy for France and Europe was the high popularity and the dissemination of modern French ideals.